This is video review for Transformers Age of Extinction Sword of Judgment. I picked this one up from TF Source, and I picked it up to be displayed for my movie advanced leader class Optimus Prime from Takara. The sword is all metal. It is basically a keychain, but you can remove the chain and use it for the display purposes as well, as I intend to. It is $9.99, so the price is fairly nice compared to others. And like I said, it's all metal. So let's take a look at the packaging. You can see Optimus Prime here behind a sword itself. On the back, the Transformers Age of Extinction movie logo. So let's take it out and see. Okay, so it is nice and heavy since it's all metal. And I really like the paint on it, as it's all metallic. You can see metallic red and blue. And what I really like are Cybertronian glyphs all over the edge. On the other side as well. Very nice touch. And I believe that's the movie accurate as well. So very nice. Like I said, I'm planning to use it with my Optimus Prime, and what I'm gonna do is just sort of force this metallic eye and sort of just twist it, and there we go. Now it's out. And let's see how it looks with a Optimus Prime. Here is Optimus Prime. And this Optimus Prime, as you could see in my review, it comes with this sword. It is larger, it is taller when standing down. So if you wanted to hold it in front of him, this would be more suitable. But if you want him to hold it differently, or even place it in his back, I would recommend this one. It goes more with the colors. Like, there's a metallic red paint apps and also blue on Optimus Prime, as well as on this sword. So I would have him carry the sword, let's say like so. So it is heavy, but he can nicely hold it, as you can see. And it really, really looks nice in his hand. And like I mentioned, you can also place it on his back as well. Just like so. And he can stand with his sword on his back. So that's very nice. And I have to say, it looks better for him to hold this one either in hand or nicely sheathed in a bag than this one. And camera doesn't pick it up. The camera picks it up as yellow. But in reality, it is really bright, bright orange. It is very orange. It's like if I make a little shade, that's how orange it is. And it's still not picking up how really bright. It's almost like a fluorescent orange, the sword is. So As you can see, this is nicely complementing the figure with the metallic colors on a sword itself. And now I can put the other one on him, and you can be judge yourself and tell me which one looks better on him. So, what do you think? I really think that the Sword of Judgment looks way better on Optimus Prime, if put it like this. And also in his arm, like so. And what is nice about this figure is, like I mentioned, it has posable or rotating wrist. So therefore, you can have him hold it so he doesn't drop it. Just like so. So, very, very nice. I believe today started a pre-order for same sword as this one, only in metallic... So not metallic, but silver blade. And basically same thing, same mold, same plastic, except this is not orange, but silver. And the price is $30, which is high, if you ask me, for a piece of plastic. If you have this figure and you really want a silver, just paint over this one. Or spend $10, which is nothing really for what you're getting, and get this Sword of Judgment, which is very, very nice. I really like the colors on it, and I love the Cybertronian glyphs. They're nice, deep, and they're not written. They're carved, they're laser etched, or they just... carved in the metal, so it's nothing that won't strip, it's nothing that would erase out or anything. It's just beautiful sword, if you ask me. So that's about it. If you have any questions, please ask me down below this video, and I'll do my best to answer your questions. And please subscribe for more videos, more reviews, and informations about upcoming customs that I make. So until next time, thanks for watching.